have to stop saying good morning because it's never morning when I do these videos. No, it's not. But I have done private readings today, so I haven't really got the time to film the rest of the April readings, but I will do it, don't you worry. But I just wanted to come on here and, you know, do a little reading with these cards. And if any of you guys want to have a private reading, all the information is down below. So that's what I have spent my day on. But I just wanted to give you guys like a little, like, daily message for you guys. I am planning on doing channeled readings as well soon. I know you guys have been waiting for that, so I will soon be doing that. I also, actually, I do want to do this, like, channeled video, like, including it more into the private readings. Because I have done a lot of... We have Waylon with us again, the neighbor's rooster. But I have done a lot of, like, past life healing with channeled messages, or where I go into, like, a state where I meet you guys' higher self and I pull out all the information that I need for you to realize what it is that you need to heal. It is something that I'm doing with private readings as well, so if you're interested in that, let me know. But should we just jump into it and see what is the message for today? Let's see. Again, this is general. Take what resonates, leave the rest. This is just going to be a little daily pep message. We have four cards, so four messages. So I will put them down and take the first one. It's funny because I had this card with one of my private readings today. Yeah. The conclusions are within reach. Full moon eclipse. I mean, I love these cards so much because the pictures are just BAM! And the magical message with this card is that if there's a slammed door in your life, it's meant to not be reopened. That is a major message. If there's any door in your life right now that's shutting, closing, slamming, it's meant to stay closed. It's meant to actually protect you from something that would have hurt you, or something that would have made you make, you know, the wrong turn or the wrong decisions. For some reason, I did feel a push in my back, so I do feel that, you know, you have a spirit guide who's gently pushing you to realizing that a closed door is actually a new opportunity. So you guys might have felt this very heavily with like physical pain, like back pain. It's also for someone out there to realize that you can't take control over this situation. You need to let it unfold naturally. That might be why I felt this back pain. So that might be for someone who's having back pain out there. You need to let this situation unfold naturally. If you're considering to let go of someone or, you know, something, this is the right time for you to let go of this person. So try to ask yourself if this is the time for you to actually let go of this person or let go of this situation. Because again, you do have to be aware if this situation or person is good for you or not. But you also have to be aware of that if you let this person go, there's no turning back. There's no, oh, I'm sorry, want to try again. No. So the next card we have is luck is on your side. We love that. This can also be, you know, a little storyline that if you let go, if you let the door be slammed, be closed, luck is going to come into your life. Did I just hit myself with this card? I want to have luck. New moon and Sagittarius. So you guys might be Sagittarius, you might have Sagittarius in your chart. I do feel for you, it would be a good idea to do scripted work like when it comes to your blessings, when it comes to your, you know, your gratitude lists, because whatever you're going to be grateful for now is going to double up, it's going to unfold naturally. Luck is, it's going to turn to luck. But I also feel that you do need to not be narrow-minded. Again, also think about what is, you know, actually hindering you in attracting luck or manifesting luck or going after your dreams and desires. Again, don't shoot arrows into the pit of darkness. Like, again, be aware of where you are actually shooting off your arrows, like your dreams and desires. And, you know, who you're giving your precious time to. But, you know, whatever is coming your way, it looks like it's going to put a smile on your face, which is pretty beautiful with this card. So the next card we have is Meditate and Contemplate. New Moon in Pisces. So some of you guys might be Pisces. But again, this can also be just a whole entire storyline, like, let go, slam the door, welcome the new, do gratitude lists, meditate, welcome the new, face your fears. This is one of the most important aspects here, and it fits well together with this card, because if you face your fears, if you let go of what you need to let go of, you know, facing your fears are a big part of doing that. Your wildest dream, if you want to be on stage and sing for hundreds of people, you're obviously going to feel that, but you know, it's what you want, so you need to step over this fear that you have, because again, fear is a stopper. It's a trickster. It's time for you to surrender to the divine, to let the universe unfold things for you again, but you do need to take action. You do need to let luck come into your life. It's time for you to let romance and poetry and love and dreams come into your life. It's time for you to not be afraid of romance or love or soulmate or, you know, the right person or your luck. Because if we think about it, we're actually afraid of what it is that we want to manifest. So you do need to realize what is it that you fear, because I am pretty sure that your fears are actually a sign for what it is that you're actually wanting to do. And fear sometimes is also a sign that new things are actually starting out coming into our life. And it's actually a mind game. It's actually interesting, because the moment that we fear is like the moment where we are standing in the queue in, you know, to the roller coaster. That is the moment that we feel fear, because that we know that, oh, suddenly something, oh, now things are going down. Now I'm going to go on this ride and I don't know how things are going to end. That is the moment when we fear, because that we know something is going to happen. So if you have fear in your body, it's because your body knows that something is going to happen. But you don't need to fear it, because again, your mind is just twisting it, because in your past you might have feared a lot of things, so the unknown is something that you turn to fear, but instead you do need to see it as your luck. And with the last card, we have emotions are running high. Yeah, fear, your emotions. You know that what it is that you want is coming your way now. And that is a little bit fearful. Something exciting lies ahead. And this is also for you to be aware of, not to ignore the obvious. Like, if you're fearing things... I just sneezed 3 times and the camera died. If that is not magical, I don't know what is. Well, can make a wish. But don't fear the obvious, because sometimes we fear stuff that's not even, you know, happened. Like, the things that we fear are never going to happen. It's like if you go on a roller coaster, you know, your body is fearing that, but nothing is going to happen, because that if you have done the ride, you're going to be like, I want to do this again. You have to see your life right now as a roller coaster that you are very scared of, but that you also know that you want more if you step into it. I feel that is the message for you guys today. Slam the door, you know, put yourself in the queue, in the line for the roller coaster, and enjoy it, because it's going to bring you a lot of emotions, you know. Yeah, because it is going to be scary, yes, because it's new, but you're also going to enjoy the ride. So with that, I hope you guys enjoyed this, you know, little mini daily reading. Let me know in the comment below if this resonated. Let me know if you are taking the roller coaster ride. Remember to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye bye.